Picture math class as you've known it. A chalkboard or whiteboard, students at desks, an instructor writing concepts, formulas, and equations for the students to copy. Questions get answered, assignments are given. Read a chapter, complete a problem set. All the answers are listed in the back of the book. Familiar? Good. Now, throw it away. In Math 111, learning happens from doing. In class, you'll spend time working through problems. And out of class, you'll do problems in the learning platform Alex, which adapts to you based on your answers. The point is, you will do, and that's how you'll learn. It'll feel different, but also exciting. So to help you get the most out of this experience, we're here to recommend 6 things to do to maximize your learning in Math 111. First, start easy. Learning by doing isn't about knowing the answer right away. It's about learning to think like a problem solver. Ask yourself what you know or don't know. Draw the problem. Put it in your own words. Identify why or where you're stuck. Say you're asked to find the extrema indicated on this graph. Do make observations. Perhaps you'll think, that graph has no sharp edges. It bends and changes direction. It goes up and down. I don't know what it's called. I don't know what an extrema is. If you don't know what an extrema is, you've identified something to find out. Don't be content to think, I don't know. Do be curious. After you find out what puzzles you, seek information. The best way to master learning by doing is to actively seek needed or additional details. Some questions will be too challenging to tackle without more detail, and some problems might feel familiar, but will benefit from greater understanding of the concept. Exploration is your chance to clarify your understanding and to determine next steps. Let's try it out. Here's that extrema again. Determine what you know and don't know and start talking to your classmates. What do they know? What can you tell them? Exchange ideas and collaborate to build on what you learn from each other. Don't give up or automatically skip the question. Do seek the evidence you need to move forward. And then answer the questions, even if you're unsure. Ever thought being wrong was bad? Well, in this course, being wrong and being willing to be wrong is great and celebrated. When your instructor or TA invites you to answer, it's because each answer from you informs them and contributes to the class learning. Answering questions is also essential to your work in Alex. When you work in Alex, it will adapt to your answers. This means that Alex will give you the next best problem based on your previous answer. So be sure to answer every question. You may learn even more from making a mistake than from answering correctly. And each answer, whether right or wrong, will get you closer to mastery. Once you've determined an answer, explain it. In learning by doing, you elevate your learning when you can explain why something works or doesn't work. So don't just answer the question, call it good, and move on. And do check your understanding by talking through your process. If you feel stuck, consider similarities and differences to previous knowledge or concepts. Or hypothesize a common mistake with this problem, or describe everything in your own words. Here you might talk about the slope being 3, the y-intercept negative 2. The slope describes the tilt of the line. The y-intercept is the place the graph intercepts the y-axis. Functions only cross the y-axis in one place. If you saw this in a word problem, the slope might be called a rate of change. Talking aloud helps you clarify your knowledge, test yourself, and make connections between ideas. This practice solidifies memory and positions you to better recall the information later, like on a test. As you work through all of these strategies, take time to think back and reflect. Every problem you engage with is a step in the process of learning math. So pause to consider how you were successful. Why the process felt challenging, what you didn't understand. This thinking helps solidify your learning. A reflection here might be, I mixed up the idea of positive and increasing. Next time I'll know. And for this you might say, now I know an extrema is a maximum or minimum value of a function. Next time, I'll be ready. Reflection illuminates your areas of strength and challenge and positions you to gauge your preparedness for upcoming exams, which leads to our final idea. Be active in your own learning. If you have questions that don't get answered in class, visit office hours. If those times aren't compatible with your schedule, arrange an appointment. This is your course. The instructor and TA are your guides. When you do meet, bring notes to show your steps and solutions and share your reflections. Take charge. Learn by doing. You've got this, and a lot of people and resources are ready to support you along the way.